People often misunderstand scientific theories, partly because science can be complicated, but also because many people are confused about what a scientific theory actually is. A theory, in science terms, is not just an extremely good educated guess, nor is it expected to ever reach a higher burden of proof. It is, in fact, a common miscommunication that a scientific theory can ever become a scientific law. This is because they aren't really part of a hierarchy of evidence, but rather separate aspects of understanding and classifying the world around us. A scientific law is something we know, and a theory is a model to explain it that has stood up to repeated testing and research. Now, since people often misunderstand what a theory is, they also often sometimes get the science confused as well, and in today's video we're going to go over 10 examples of that happening. Number 10. Many people ask, if we evolved from monkeys, why are there still monkeys? Something you will often hear from people who deny the theory of evolution is that it is silly to say we evolved from monkeys because there are still monkeys around today. Now, this shows two major misunderstandings of how evolution works and shows that many people are simply arguing from a place of ignorance. To begin with, we didn't evolve from monkeys, at least not from the ones that you're thinking of and the ones you see around today. We actually evolved from a common ancestor to monkeys many, many years ago. A new species evolving from an old one doesn't necessarily mean the old species is obsolete, nor that it will suddenly vanish from the face of the Earth. There's also the matter of how more genetic diversity is created. When a group from a species ends up isolated from other members of its species, different forms tend to emerge due to the different environments or habits of the group. There are many, many different forms of monkeys today, which makes sense with the theory of evolution. We are just the smartest kind of monkey. Number 9. Time is one of the most misunderstood ideas in all of science. Time is something we take for granted every day, but in the physics community, its nature and existence is a source of constant research and debate. Some people aren't even sure that it's even really a thing, at least not in the way that we tend to think of it. Experiments with a unit of measure even smaller than an atom on something called the Planck scale, which is a scale for incredibly small measurements, have found that time seems to cease when you get down to a small enough level. Some physicists think that this could indicate that at the very basic level of the universe, time simply doesn't exist, which would mean that what we think we are seeing is just a macroscopic effect of something else entirely. This can be quite confusing even to the trained physicist, and there really is no one truly defined explanation accepted by the majority of the community. Some are trying all sorts of equations and ideas in an attempt to come up with some sort of overall rationale, but so far they've not succeeded. The problem is that time already threw physicists for a bit of a loop when Einstein proved that it was at least relative. Now physicists have to figure out whether it actually exists at the most base level of the universe, and if it does, in what form, and, well, what exactly is it? For now, though, you're gonna have to accept the illusion because you still need to show up for work on time. Number 8. The law of averages doesn't really exist. It's a fallacy. Some people will talk about something called the law of averages, whereby they claim that over a given amount of time, things will basically even out in terms of odds. Usually, this is applied to some sort of competition or even to gambling. The thing is, though, there really is no such thing as the law of averages. It's actually just a fallacy. The law of averages generally assumes that because something is statistically likely, that means it's going to happen soon. This fallacy can be a part of the gambler's fallacy, where people lose a lot of money because they continue to bet because the law of averages says that it should happen imminently. The problem is that these people have a poor understanding of probability. If we're talking about truly random chance, just because something is likely to happen doesn't mean it will happen. There is just a level of probability that it will happen. Calculating probability can be quite complicated, and the number usually ends up lower than you would expect. There is a real concept that people might be getting things confused with called the law of large numbers. This simply posits that if you do something an incredible amount of times, the average should be close to the expected value. For example, if you roll a six-sided dice hundreds of thousands of times, the average should be about 3.5. That is because this is the average value of the die. Some people get confused thinking that in a specific gambling run, or perhaps a game of Risk, that luck will even out eventually. However, this is unlikely. The sample size is too small, and you're simply falling prey to the gambler's fallacy. Number 7. Gender and sex are constantly confused, but they're not the same thing. Today, there is a lot of talk about various different genders, such as pansexual, demisexual, and things like that. On top of that, there is increased awareness and tolerance for those who are transgender. However, just because everyone is talking about these things doesn't mean that everyone necessarily understands the concepts. Some people get very confused about the difference between gender and sex, and the difference is actually pretty important. We aren't here to weigh in on how many genders there should be or how you should feel about people who think they were born with a different sex. We just want to get to what's scientifically accurate. When it comes to sex, there can really only be two. You simply cannot make up any more than that, because sex consists of the physiological characteristics, such as the actual differences in organs and the different hormones that naturally affect you. However, gender has always been a sociological construct, and you can have as many of those as you want. It's got nothing to do with physical characteristics. Gender is really about how you feel, what attracts you, and other nebulous factors that can't properly be physiologically measured. Number 6. The artificial intelligence scientists are building is not what you think it is. Artificial intelligence is probably one of the most misunderstood basic scientific theories in science. Movies have done an incredibly good job of twisting people's understanding of artificial intelligence, and unless you've studied computer science, you might not realize quite how silly and wrong most movies have this. In movies, artificial intelligence reaches some sort of consciousness, and people are quite used to this image of AI. To make matters worse, the news will get quick clicks, with headlines about a famous scientist being worried about the rise of AI, and then people will start worrying about Terminators or something like that. Now, there is some reason to be worried about AI, but no researcher expects them to reach actual consciousness, because it's just not how it works. Rather, the goal of AI research is to make them better at doing tasks and organizing the flow of various goings-on without having to have human intervention. The fear of experts is AI making bad decisions after being given control of important infrastructure, not because they have transcended to the level of conscious beings and are being malicious. What the big problem is that they make stupid mistakes because they have a lack of context and they don't see the entire picture as a human would. There's also the problem that their thinking could be unpredictable. Number 5. Survival of the fittest isn't about strength or immunity, but characteristics. A lot of people are taught about the theory of natural selection, but many of them come away with little memory of it except the survival of the fittest thing, which many take to mean that if you are the strongest and the toughest, you're more likely to survive. However, this is only really the case if those characteristics are what are most likely to get you to pass on your genes to a new generation. This is because the whole point of natural selection is to choose those with the best characteristics for the environment that they live in. Species not only tend to naturally select over time for better traits, but also will drop things over time that they don't need anymore. A good example of this is wisdom teeth, which some humans are already being born without. Number 4. Everything you know about Pavlov's experiments and theories is probably wrong. Ivan Pavlov is most famous for his experiments with dogs, where he taught them to salivate at the sound of a buzzer. He did this, as you probably know, by making them associate the sound of that buzzer with being fed. Most people think that Pavlov's whole deal from the get-go was studying psychology by using dogs, and that no dogs were harmed in his experiments. However, the truth is that the real story behind Pavlov is kind of horrifying if you really like dogs. If horrifying things happening to dogs is something that you're not into, I would recommend that you turn this off now. Still here? Alright, well, Pavlov was not really interested in a career in psychology. That all came much later, after he had already won a Nobel Prize and had reached the peak of his career. Rather, Pavlov was interested in physiology, especially when it came to the digestive system. He would do something called sham feeding, where he would make a hole in the dog's throat called a fistula so that the food would drop out and never reach the dog's stomach. By continuing to make lower holes on various dogs, he was able to measure excretions at various levels, and his comprehensive picture of the digestive system won him a Nobel Prize in 1904 for physiology and medicine. While he did do some later psychological research with dogs, a bell was almost never one of the sounds that he used to trigger the dog's association with food. Number 3. Freud's most disturbing theories about sexuality were never taken that seriously. Many people today think of most of Freud's absurd theories about young children or infants having unconscious sexual thoughts, and they not only scoff, but they wonder what the medical community was thinking, taking such nonsense so seriously. However, the truth was that Freud had one of the most complex careers, and also has one of the most complex legacies when it comes to his work. While people were interested in his ideas on psychoanalysis, the importance of dreams, and his general belief in a subconscious, it is important to understand that even during his time, his more radical ideas about unconscious sexual thoughts in children were not really accepted by most in the medical community. It is also important to understand that today, the psychological community thinks of most of Freud's theories as a joke, and they don't really teach him that seriously in classes. But that doesn't mean they've thrown out the baby with the bathwater. Freud may not be a huge influence today, but psychologists believe that it is important to study him from a historical perspective because of the huge influence he had on early psychology. Now, while psychology doesn't exactly believe in the breakdown of the subconscious quite the way that Freud described it, a subconscious is a widely accepted idea, and we have Freud to thank for that. And while his practice of psychoanalysis, which is the talk therapy where you try to understand the unconscious thoughts, is not that popular among psychologists anymore, there are those who practice it and some who incorporate elements of it into their therapy repertoire. Number 2. Black holes are accepted by most, but their nature and existence is controversial. Black holes are something most of us understand very well. You can't see them, but you know they are there because they are dragging light and matter into them, like, well, a black hole. However, back in the 1980s, Stephen Hawking shocked the scientific community when he used the quantum laws of physics to prove that black holes were actually emitting particles, something now known as Hawking radiation. Now, this is where things get really tricky, because we still don't fully understand black holes today. Hawking's research contends that since the black hole is losing heat and matter, it will eventually dissolve like an aspirin in a glass of water instead of continuing to just suck up light and matter without pause. However, this leads to the question of where the information that was sucked up goes to when the black hole dissolves. Some physicists contend that, according to our knowledge of the laws of the universe, no information can be lost forever, but Hawking disagreed, wagering that the information would be lost. At this point, physicists can only scratch their heads, as we really have absolutely no way of knowing. We have never been able to witness a black hole dissolving in order to find out. Number 1. You may have seen some confusing claims that electrons can go faster than light. This is something that's been passed around the internet, and it's even confused some kids in science classes when well-meaning teachers didn't explain it properly. People heard that electrons can go faster than light, and everyone got all excited about how we have allegedly cracked the speed of light barrier. However, the unfortunate truth was that no such thing has occurred. Electrons can move faster than light when they are sped up enough, but only in a medium that already slows down the speed of light moving through it. This is a known phenomenon at nuclear reactors that creates a really cool-looking blue glow effect. This is known as Cherenkov radiation. In this context, it's very easy for a flashy media headline to confuse people into thinking that there was some amazing breakthrough about breaking the speed of light. As with everything, it's really important to read the fine print. Pertinent here is that faster than light and faster than the speed of light are not the same thing at all. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up below, and do not forget to subscribe. Got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. If you're looking for more from me, why not check out my other channel called Biographics? You will find that linked to below. And as always, thank you for watching.